you have probably had in your life a nurse give you a shot. You've probably in your life had a nurse give you a vaccination. That's a relatively simple medical procedure that a nurse is most competent to do, that a nurse is quite competent to do. And there are plenty of simple and uncontroversial medical procedures that I think we need to look at to see that, see if we can extend the ability to do simple and uncomplicated medical procedures. I think we need to look at the possibility of having physician assistants or nurses being able to do those. That's the way they do it in many other countries. It leads to a huge decrease in cost. It doesn't lead to any kind of decrease in safety. I think that we're capable of having medical professionals deliver us, deliver medical services that we need without the kind of cost that are associated with them. And I think we're entitled to that. That's something else that's going to decrease costs substantially. That's something we're capable of doing on the state level.
Human rights to
limited government. Let me say just a few words about that. The Constitution does not give Congress the power to require that Americans purchase health insurance. Congress has to be able to point to a clause in the Constitution as the basis of any legislation that it passes. And none of the constitutional powers justify the individual insurance mandate. Congress's powers to tax and spend don't apply. The mandate doesn't tax, it doesn't spend. The only other option is Congress's power to regulate commerce. Now, some people think that that power to regulate commerce is universal, that Congress has as much power to regulate anything as the Soviet Union did to its citizens, you know, in the day before 1990. And Congress has stretched its power to regulate commerce many times. But what the Supreme Court says is that there are limits, and particularly, Congress has never been able to regulate economic activity in which individuals choose to engage. Congress has always been able to require individuals to, Congress has always been able to regulate activity where people choose to engage on an interstate level, but it's never been able to require individuals to engage in economic activity. That's not a difference in degree, that's a difference in kind. And if you look at the Supreme Court, what the Supreme Court wrote in Lopez, which is a decision about 15 years ago, the Supreme Court was quite clear that there are real limits to Congress's power to regulate us all through the Commerce Clause.